Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel Electrical Technology and Industrial Practice. So today you can see that our topic is momentary paralleling. Now you know that paralleling of transformer, paralleling of generators, you know these things, this information can be found in books. But in this video we will discuss about the momentary application of paralleling. Okay, so why the momentary application is selected instead of continuous paralleling, in this video we will be discussing about that. So let's begin the video. Why normal paralleling is not done in distribution level, there is a reason. Okay, the main reason is that if you use continuous paralleling in distribution level, the fault current will increase. Suppose you have a system like this, you have one transformer and this is another transformer. Your total load demand is say 2 MVA. Okay. Now you can select this transformer as 1.25 MVA and this transformer as 1.25 MVA. Okay. So by this you will get the load of this, the 2 MVA load will be delivered. But what happened? Say this 1.25 MVA transformer is with 6% percentage impedance. This is also 6% percentage impedance. Now if you run these two transformer in parallel, their effective impedance will be 3%. Okay. So their fault level will increase. So that is why, and there is another disadvantage that if there is any fault in one transformer is out of service, so the effective source will be reduced. So that is why parallel operation of transformer, continuous paralleling in transformer is not generally used in distribution level. Distribution level, mind it, that means at low power level, 2.5 MVA, 3.15 MVA, or at HT level, maybe 20, 25 MVA, 30 MVA, okay. But in the transmission level, where the generators are connected with generator transformer, their parallel operation is, continuous parallel is done. But in lower level distribution, inside a plant distribution, there is the continuous paralleling is not generally used. Instead of that, momentary paralleling is used. Now we will be seeing that why the momentary paralleling is used. Okay. So suppose let us consider this picture. Okay. So here you can see that there is incomer 1, which is source 1, and this is incomer 2, that is source 2. Okay. Now suppose this breaker is at closed condition. Okay, so this is NC and this is NO, this is at open condition. Now, so suppose this incomer 1 is taking care of the load. Now you want to take this incomer 1 in maintenance and want to shift the load to this incomer 2. Okay, so how will you do? Number one way is you switch off this incomer 1 and then you switch on this incomer 2. Now what will be the disadvantage here? When you switch off the incomer 1, then all the loads will be switched off. Okay, so after switching on the incomer 2, you need to switch on all the loads. So your system has to be restarted. So this can be avoided by momentary paralleling. So momentary paralleling is a basically a manual transfer of source without interrupting the power supply to the loads. Okay. So as this is a manual transfer, so the auto manual switch needs to be placed at manual. Often it is indicated as auto independent manual switch. So this auto manual switch shall be at manual position. This breaker can be controlled as automatic mode or in manual mode. Manual mode means where the operator can manually switch on or switch off a breaker. Now I will discuss later in this in different video with the breaker operating principle, how the switch actually works. Now just understand this thing, that the auto manual switch will be at manual position. Now there is another selector switch, there will be, that is trip selector switch or TSS. What is the function of this? When I close this breaker, these two sources will come parallel, so I need to trip this breaker. Okay, so our trip selector switch will be at incomer 1 position. It is mistakenly shown is incomer 2 position. It will be at incomer 1 position, okay, because our incomer 1 will be tripped. So this trip selector switch will be at here, at incomer 1, because our incomer 1 is closed and we want to take this to incomer 2. we want to maintain income or 1 and we want to take the load to income or 2. If it is reversed, if we want to maintain income or 2 and take and shift entire load in income or 1, then our income or trip selector switch will be at income or 2. Okay, so there are two possibilities. If this is income or 1, if this is income or 2, then if our load is at getting fed from income or 2, then we will place it at income or 2. Okay, because we want to trip income or 2 and want to close income or 1. But here in this video which I am explaining, I have said that income or 1 is in normally closed condition and income or 2 is in normally open condition. So we want to close income or 2. So our trip selector switch position will be at income or 1. So it will be moved to at income or 1 position, right? So now what we will do? We will give the closing command to income or 2. Income or 2 will be check the 25 relay or the synchro check relay will check the voltage between these two line PTs. Two voltage will be checked, and if these are in sync, then it will allow the income or 2 to close. Okay, and it will energize the timer which will after some time which will trip this income or 1. Now if the income or 1 is not tripped due to some reason, then the timer will trip this income or 2, or the source 2 which is incoming source will be tripped, so that the sustained paralleling is avoided. Okay, now let us see another example where we will use three source. Okay, where we will use three source. So say there is transformer 1, transformer 2, these are source 1 and source 2. So these two breakers are normally closed and the bus coupler is normally open. So this transformer is feeding this portion of the load and this transformer is feeding this portion of the load. Now here say we want to take the transformer 2 in maintenance. Okay, we want this transformer in maintenance. So what we will do, we have to shift the entire load to transformer 1. So we need to close the bus coupler and we need to open the incomer 2. So how will we do? Again, our auto manual independent switch will be at manual position. And so this is I am explaining case 1. Here you can see that our trip selector switch is at incomer 2 position. Okay, so incomer 2 will be tripped. Now we will give closing command to bus coupler. The bus coupler will first close. So at that time these two transformer will be parallel. Then the timer will give a trip signal to this breaker. Okay, and if the breaker fails to open, then the timer will send a trip signal to bus coupler so that the system remains as it was. That means the two incomer is closed and bus coupler is open. So in case this breaker incomer 2 breaker fails to open, then the incoming breaker will be opened. Okay, so that the sustained paralleling is avoided. Now suppose now let us check the case 2 condition. So what is our now operating condition? That the transformer 1 is taking care of the entire bus load. Now suppose our transformer 2 has been maintained and we want to take back our transformer 2 into circuit. So what we will do, we will close incomer 2 and we will trip bus coupler. So our trip selector switch will be at bus coupler. Okay, then we will give closing command to incomer 2. The synchro check relay will check the status of the voltage and it will give closing command to incomer 2 and tripping command to bus coupler. Okay, remember this momentary paralleling is a make before break operation. Okay, that means here at first the closing operation will be done, then the tripping operation will be done. Okay, so always remember that first it will be closed, then it will be tripped. Now another application of momentary paralleling I am showing you, which is indicated as case 3. As I have mentioned that there is another automatic mode. Okay, so what is automatic mode? What happens in automatic mode? Generally these switch gears are often interlocked in auto bus transfer scheme. That means suppose these two incomers are operating. Okay, these two incomers are normally operating. So this transformer is taking load and this transformer is taking load. This bus coupler is open and here there is load, here there is load. Now suppose this transformer has faced any problem. Okay, so what will happen? Here the line PT connected, here the line PT will see under voltage. So this breaker will be opened. Here this breaker will be opened. So when this breaker will open, there is a logic that this bus coupler will be automatically closed to take care of the loads unless there is a fault at this position. So how this will be checked? See, there are relays connected, 51 51N connected. So these are all connected with 86 or lockout relay. So this bus coupler will check two condition. Number one is that this line PT has gone under voltage. The PT or the under voltage relay connected here, 27 connected here, has got under voltage and no 86 has been operated. That is, there is no fault but only under voltage due to some reason. So what will happen? This breaker will be opened and this breaker will be closed. Okay, this is a break before make operation. So here, suppose something like that has happened and the auto changeover has been occurred, and now the transformer 1 is taking care of the entire load. Now we have maintained our transformer 2 and we want to take back this transformer 2 into circuit. So what we will do, we will again in the case 3, our again incoming will be incomer 2 and we will trip the bus coupler. So our auto manual selection will be at manual mode, our bus coupler trip selector switch will be at bus coupler. We will give closing command to incomer 2 and then the bus coupler will be opened so that our original operating condition restored. Okay, so this is how the momentary paralleling works. I have explained the working principle of momentary paralleling, how this is executed, what are the changeover we need to make. Okay, in the second part I will be explaining the control logics, the logic diagram, that how the logic is developed, that what I am saying, that the selector switch will be at manual position, the trip selector switch, how the interlocks will be done. In the upcoming video I will explain those things, so that the entire momentary paralleling, its operation and its schematic implementation control circuit is clear to you. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you enjoyed, please like, share, comment and subscribe to our channel, and also please hit the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Thank you very much for watching this video.